Oh geez, oh no, no, coming in fast. Okay, whoops. Oh, where's the sun? Oh, I'm in build mode. This way. Ahoy, salty dogs! Welcome to the Star Squadron server. My name is Lenscap, and today we are gonna work on a few things. First and foremost, I want to kind of recap what we did last episode for those of you who missed it. I do implore you to go check out the video on my channel if you haven't seen it yet. We like to build some awesome things here in StarMade and other games as well. So to recap, we've been working on this station called the Hub Pub. The Hub Pub is a temporary name. Last episode, I asked for suggestions for the proper name of the station, and I got some really fantastic suggestions from you guys. So I haven't decided on one yet, but I do encourage you to continue to leave suggestions in the comments section below. I'm always, excuse me, I'm always happy to hear what you think of the station. But I definitely dig some of the ideas we're getting. I really like it. So we talked about we worked on the exterior of the hub pub, and we got some cool shapes going on. We've got like this dish area, which is gonna be kind of we're gonna set up an interior there where other members on the server can come hang out. It's like a neutral meeting ground with where, you know, anybody is welcome and anyone can come without having to worry about the hostilities that we have going on between various factions on the server. So I feel like that's always important to have. It's also going to be a shop so that if you want to come purchase things, come buy it from old Lenscap because I need to be filthy rich. So yeah, the solar sail. We built a docking area. We've got the hub pub area actually. And then I decided we needed to power it all. So I built a solar sail underneath. I feel like it came out okay. I like the way it looks. It's kind of sci-fi floating there. But it gave me some ideas for another project we're going to work on today. We probably will come back to this later in the episode, if we have time, and work on this a little bit further, just because this is a great project that I really want to see finished, especially since it's a community kind of thing. I want some input though. What do you think about this solar sail? It's cool, it's okay. I think it's gonna stay probably in its current iteration because it just kind of fits with the rest of the build, and this really was a template idea. Well, you'll see. I really like what it turned into though. Okay, so I also have these cargo pods docked to it down here, and this I'm not sure if this is gonna stay. If you kind of cover here, I'm gonna park right here. We'll tab G. Cover up the pods with like your thumb or your hand or something, and tell me if you think the station is more balanced with or without it, like visually balanced. I kind of feel like it's more visually balanced without the cargo pods there, so we may need to come up with another way to implement the pods onto the station. Now, this is a trading station primarily, so it does have to have cargo pods somewhere docked to it. I feel like that is crucial for a trading station. Now, I guess I could potentially dock them maybe closer to each other and make it a little bit more compact. But I do kind of like this 45-degree angle on like this pod and this pod. I think that works out really well. I also would like to get in touch with a few other members of the Star Squadron server and get them, maybe purchase some goods from them so that I can get their pods as well. Because yeah, I pretty much exclusively use my pods, and which is fine. That's what I made them for me to use. But I have noticed in pretty much everybody else's videos when they're working on pods, my pods are in the background too, which I think that's awesome. I love seeing my work in other people's videos, especially on the Star Squadron server. It brings joy to my heart seeing my pods in the background. But I want, it's a trading hub, so I need to have trading happening. And if only my pods are parked here, there's clearly no trading happening, and that's bad for business. So, solar sail is cool. Let me know what you think of the solar sail. But it's probably going to stay as is, honestly, just partially because I'm too lazy to change it, And partially because I think it looks okay. It worked out just fine for this kind of iteration of the station. I do have one further project that I want to work on today. So we're going to go take care of that really quick. I have something really cool to show you guys. This solar sail kind of inspired me to make a new ship. So I made, it's just a shuttlecraft. It's nothing fancy. It doesn't even work very well, but it looks awesome. I'm thinking about maybe entering it into the fleet competition that StarMade is putting on right now. So we may have to build several ships over the next couple of weeks as the competition progresses. Hopefully I can get a fleet finished. I'm not a very fast builder when it comes to ships. But I'm going to get a few things together. We're going to have to get a blueprint and then fill it out. So let's get started on that. All right, so we have returned to the Salty Shipyard. I've set my personal cargo back to the proper cargo thing that I hear, whatever. Let's go ahead and we need to buy our blueprint. So we're going to go into the catalog. I called it the Junk Shuttle for now. You can see it doesn't have very many good stats. It's mobile, but that's about it. All right, we're going to buy this blueprint. And now we actually need to fill it. So let's put it in this chest so we can switch to our cargo. And then we can take it back out of the chest. That's a little oversight on my part. But what we're going to do is let's go ahead and see what all we can go ahead and add now before we try and fill it in. Yeah, I got a lot of work to do. So I'm going to go to the crafting area and build the rest of this stuff. We'll spawn the ship in. Alright, so that is nearly everything. We still have a couple of things to get that I just, for whatever reason, don't have the materials for. So, we're just gonna hop in the eyes and ears and fly over to the shop and purchase that stuff. Oh, geez. Oh, no, no. Coming in fast. Okay. Whoops. We're stuck. We're stuck. Roll. Yes. It's working. Okay, now we're free. oops. There was a failure in piloting. My bad. I'm usually a pretty good pilot. All right. So we've got the things we need. We just need to go ahead and dock the ship and get them into our cargo thing. We are out of gravity, but that's fine. We just need to go down to the manufacturing area. No, we need to go to the pod control room. That's where our storage is. And drop these things off in a chest there. Then we can finish up that blueprint and spawn in the ship. Now, there are a couple of changes, actually, that I'm going to make to it. So, they are very minor changes, but I noticed that I had a couple superfluous blocks while building this, so I probably will remove those, and this won't necessarily be our final iteration, but it's basically the last thing. It's gonna look the same. Fungal trap. Shoot, I got the wrong kind of fungus. I grabbed a fungal something else. So we need to figure out where to get a fungal trap. Are those on the red planets, right? Oh, look, we've got one right over here. And I've never been there, so that'll give me an excuse to go visit a planet. All right, so this is a little bit of an adventure today. let's hop in the eyes and ears again, since it is our fastest ship, and we'll use that to take us to the red planet so we can grab some mushrooms. I've got a decorative mushroom in here, but we may as well, oh gosh, you know, I don't know if this ship is strong enough to leave atmosphere, so I'm hoping, well, yeah, it's gotta be, right? I got some crazy overdrive on it. I guess we'll find out. So I need specifically a fungal trap, but we could definitely handle getting some other things too. So let's see, if we jump, how close can we get? Portion of my jump drive is already charged. Jumping exactly there, great. And the planet should be right there, she is. All right, so let's fly down to the planet and see if we can't find some fungal traps. I'm sure we can. Let's let it load in and find a good flat-ish spot for us to touch down. Looks like this plate is loading in the fastest, and I see a good flat spot there. So here we go. Okay. Right here should be good. And we'll try and gently. All right, I think we're down. No. Yeah, close enough. Once we hop out, it'll settle. Beautiful. So now we just need to grab a couple of these things. Let's see, this is what we want here. That's not what I wanted. This is the fungal trap. Yeah, fungal trap. Let's grab a couple of these mushrooms while we're here, since I don't have any. I haven't done very much work or exploration on planets this season of Star Squadron. There's not a lot of reason to go to the planets, honestly. So I haven't been to very many. Alright, whatever. We're just going to grab a couple of mushrooms. We don't need to clear the place out or anything. Get a couple more of these fungal traps. I really like the way they work. They look, so. Okay, that should be good. Now we gotta fly back and fill up the rest of that blueprint. Meanwhile, back at the base. Alright, we can go ahead and fill the blueprint as soon as I dock. I definitely want to get some docking maneuvers going on first. Ooh. Don't crash into the station this time, Lenscap. Oh, jeez. I'm usually a decent pilot. I don't know. I'm sorry. There we go. Okay. Now we're docked. We gotta drop these off in the chest. I wonder if I can access it from here. That's not what I meant to do. Can I set inventory name? Can I switch the name to inventory? No, because it's on a different structure. Alright, fine. Hop in some gravity. I missed the gravity. Okay, there we go. I just like being in gravity. I don't know if I can explain it. I don't know that I can explain it. Alright, so we just gotta drop off these mushrooms, and then we can spawn in our ship. Oh my gosh. Guys, I am so excited for this ship. I think this is a new era of Star Squadron for Lenscap, honestly. It's so good. It's so much better. I don't want to talk it up too much in case you guys think it sucks. But I feel like it's so much better than any other ships I've built before. And if we can set a precedent with this one and kind of, you know, like we're thinking fleets now. So this kind of changes the whole way we're going to play this game going forward. Like, the cargo pods were huge, but now we're going to build one fleet. We're going to have to start thinking fleets, and we're going to have to start thinking bigger than just each ship working on its own, through its own merits. And we're going to have to start, building several ships that work together, and so we can take advantage of the new fleet system, which I haven't even touched yet. I'm really excited to check this out. So, add all. We got it. So let's exit the station. Well, no, let's go ahead and spawn it in. Let's go ahead and spawn it in, see where it puts it. It shouldn't put it anywhere dangerous, necessarily. So, info spawn. I just called it the Junk Shuttle. I don't have a name for this, fleet yet. We're going to leave it called Junk Shuttle. Oh, there it is. You can already get a good look at it. I just called it the Junk Shuttle. I did have an idea for a naming convention. If we're going for a fleet, right, then we we need more than just a name for each ship. We need a convention to name all of them. So I was thinking about naming them all synonyms for thief. So like we call this one the bandit, and we call the next one the fence. You know, different kinds of thieves or bandits or corsair. You know, I looked up synonyms for pirate as well, and they just weren't... let's go out this way. Let's turn off our gravity. We'll fly over to it. Oh, yeah. So it's just a shuttle. It's just a shuttle. But I really like it. I really like it. The solar sails are so cool to me. I think it really, really is a really nice touch. It took me a while to figure out where to put the skull logo because there's not a lot of blank space on the hull of it. But I think putting it on the sails is good. Now, I played around with a couple different blocks for the skull as well, but I just settled on white crystal armor. I think that looks the best. So let's do a fly around. We'll talk about some of the neat features of the ship that I like. First of all, the shape of it is cool. So the idea was it's a junker, right? It's put together from pieces of other ships, and it just kind of works. I feel like the scaffolding is what makes it feel like a junky ship. I feel like being able to see systems helps with that as well. The kind of exposed engines adds to that, which... Check out these engines. What do you guys think of the engines? I've got lava there kind of acting like a heat sink. Now, I know that having a heat sink on the side of your engines really kind of doesn't make a lot of sense because it feels like it transfers power out of the engines the wrong direction. But maybe because the sail is so good, the engines are too powerful and they'll explode if we don't have it or something. We can kind of work that out. I stayed with the dark gray hull that I use, so it still kind of fits with my current ships. I added the brown armor, quote unquote, because most of it's just hull, but I feel like it looks good. It feels junky. I like that. I've still got the light blue intakes that I do on my ships. I like it. I feel like it turned out really, really well. Man, I love the solar sails so much. All right, let's hop in the ship and take a look. It doesn't have a true airlock, so that is something to think about. There is, in here somewhere, there are two transporter controllers. For whatever reason, or the blueprint needed two, so I have no idea where the other one is. Clearly there's one right here, but there it is. I found it. That's it. Okay, so we're going to have to do a little bit of changing to this and kind of cleaning it up a little bit. There are a couple other superfluous blocks I felt like that I could remove and maybe add power generation because that's where this ship lacks a little bit. But yeah, we got a nice spacious interior. There's room for cargo. It's just a shuttle, so it doesn't have to be, like, super fancy inside. But I did try and add some interesting, you know, some interesting things. We've got a transporter. All right, let's fly it. Let's take a look at the specs of the thing. So the core is right here in the front, and you actually... There's a camera here, but you pilot it from the core primarily. If we go into build mode and turn off this, we can kind of look at the stats. You see I've moved my stats up to the top left. Of it. So let's get a view of the ship that I like, and then we'll take a look. But it doesn't have a battery. It doesn't need one. It recharges at 18,000 energy per second, has very, very, very minor shields, but it's just a shuttle, so it doesn't really need that stuff, in my opinion. As far as systems, it has a radar jammer and a jump drive. It looks like the jump drive is charged, so let's go ahead and uncharge it by flying, by jumping. Now, my biggest complaint, or my only complaint about this shuttle, is that you cannot fully charge the jump drive and move at the same time. I just don't have the energy capacity for it. So, but if we quit moving, if we let our energy fill up and we quit like accelerating, then we should be able to charge the jump drive before the energy drains all the way while we have the radar jammer active. That was my biggest thing. It has to work with the jammer active because it only has like 1800 shields and has no like weapons or anything. So the radar jammer has to stay active. Which is fine. I think the eyes and ears works the same way. You can't charge the jump drive while you move, so that works just fine. So let's go ahead and set our waypoint back for... Let's see. Do we need to go this way? Yeah. Back to the salty shipyard. And we'll head back home with our jump drive. But that is the ship. I'm really digging it. I want to build a fleet next. So the next ship we're going to have to work on is going to be a... fighter. That's the next size. We got to make a fighter. So the next size of ship is going to be a fighter. We may make a frigate as well, and then a transport vessel, I'm thinking, are going to be the four ships that we enter into the fleet. I'm not going to do a salvager of this style. These are pirates-ish, maybe. So they don't need a salvager. They want guns, which kind of suits my play style as well. If I need a salvager, I got the Dragoon, so... or the Lancer even. I think the Lancer is still the best salvager I have. And I crashed into the station once again. I'm a terrible pilot. I'm so sorry. All right, salty dogs. That's going to be all the time we have for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you like the spaceship that we built in this episode. Or I guess that we spawned in this episode. We didn't really build it now. But I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoy the idea. We will work on more of the same pretty soon. We've got to get a fleet going, especially with the competition going on. You know, we want to win this. We want to be in the game officially. That'd be awesome. And yeah, we'll just kind of play it by ear, though, and see what happens. But if you liked the video, make sure you hit that like button. I definitely appreciate it. It really helps me out. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Stay tuned.